Coilovers are often one of the first modifications to a car and are definitely one of the most functional. But how do they work? There are two main parts to a coilover. You have the shock and the spring. The shock is mainly meant for controlling the vehicle's movements, and it does so by using fluid. To understand how it does this, we have to look at what's happening inside of the shock. The main tube of a shock is called a pressure tube, and inside of it, there's hydraulic fluid, and then there's a piston that's attached to a rod. Anytime your car moves, the piston moves as well, and the hydraulic fluid provides resistance against it. And the faster that piston moves, the more resistance there is. There are also small valves on the piston that help control how fast it can move through the fluid. This is going to affect ride quality and handling, which is why a lot of coilover brands, such as BC Racing, offer custom valving. It allows you to customize your coilovers to perfectly suit your needs. The second part of the coilover is the spring, and the spring's main job is to absorb impacts. And it does this by being a spring. It absorbs impacts by storing energy from force placed on it and exerting that stored energy in the opposite direction. The amount of energy it can absorb depends on the spring rate. Spring rate is the amount of weight needed to move the spring 1 inch. So while springs with higher rates may be able to absorb more energy, it will also provide a stiffer ride. Shocks are great at controlling your vehicle's movements, but not so great at absorbing impacts and do not store much energy, which is why the spring is a necessary component of the coilover. And that's it for today's video. Let us know what topics we should cover in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any future videos.